What's up, everybody? Will Borza here, the LA Recordist, and today we're talking about these bad boys.
The Kali Audio LP6 Studio Monitors.
It's the analog vlog. It's a vlog analog. So what do I have to say about these speakers? Let's start with the price point. These speakers go for $299 USD. That is not for just one, but for both. $300 for the pair of Kali Audio LP6s. In my opinion, these speakers blow away all speakers in that price range. These speakers are miles ahead to anything comparable in price. The low end is like butter. Just truly, it is. I'm amazed by how much low end these little 6.5-inch cones can put off, but apparently they have these magnets that are like, I don't know, about that big inside these cones that just like, dynamic range is just off the chain. The accuracy of these speakers boggles my mind for how economical they are price-wise. The high end, the mid-range, very accurate. I do appreciate that these little tweeters here, they can't be dented in. They just like snap right back, which is really nice. I've run into issues there before. Yeah, on the back, you can see this chart here. There's these switches here that sort of alter the EQ so that whether you're placing these on your desk or up against a wall, or on your desk up against a wall, or on your desk away from the wall, or above your desk up against any option you could possibly think of where you're going to place these speakers in the room, there is an EQ curve that you can dial in to make these speakers sound optimal in that position. So even if you don't have any acoustic treatment in your room, these speakers will put you miles ahead of any other speakers just for this feature alone.
So as for ins and outs, we have XLR, TRS, and RCA. So anything you could possibly have, you can throw at this guy. Standard power cable, power's built in, which is nice. These are your EQ attenuators. There's a mode for RCA if you want to use that. Kind of cleans up the signal a little bit. And a volume attenuator, +6 all the way down to negative infinity, and 0 is detented, so you know where line level is. This port here on the front doesn't look like a standard port that you've ever seen. This curve and the square, it's actually designed specifically this way, and there's more that you can't see on the inside to push the audio out at an even velocity from every possible position on this surface here, because if things are being pushed out at different speeds, you get this weird like rumble, gurgly stuff that's not fun. And in a standard port, if you've listened to one of those, you can kind of hear what I mean. But this port is a really phenomenal engineering feat that adds a whole lot of value to the sound that's being produced. It really helps to define the dynamics of the songs that you're listening to.
Now, comparing these to this wall of sound that's behind me here, these aren't necessarily speakers meant for a room like this. These speakers are gonna work best for you if they're right in front of you, if you can almost reach out and touch them. Near field is like probably your best bet with these. If I am just really cranking up the volume in this room, most of the speakers behind me, spare the Yamaha NS10s, I will actually feel the music in my chest. The speakers will push air at me, and I will actually feel the music, not just hear the music. Don't do that for too long, you'll just totally destroy your ears. But, you know, short blasts of high energy music really does help you kind of hear what's going on and how your music is gonna be felt. From this distance, probably 3 meters away, I wasn't really able to feel air being pushed at me with these speakers, but that's not really what they're designed to do. They are designed to be in front of you, fairly close, on your desk or right behind your desk, that kind of thing. And probably in that position, you would be able to hear these speakers push some air and really make you feel the music. That being said, this is not your everyday room here. Most people watching this video don't have a room like this. I don't have a room like this. So in your studio apartment studio, these are just gonna be sublime. These will fill every need you could possibly have. If you don't have any other monitors, these will work excellent as your mains. If you do have other monitors, these will work excellent as secondary monitors, so you can hear your music from a different perspective. And for the price point, I mean, a decent pair of headphones is gonna be $300. Another set of powered studio monitors that sound phenomenal, to me, that's a no-brainer. So how would I personally use these speakers? I would use these in a smaller listening environment than the one I'm standing in. If you just have a smaller desk where you can place them on the desk, that would be ideal. They'd make a really good living room speaker as well if you just want like a hi-fi setup to entertain your guests, turntable, that kind of thing. And I would absolutely place these on a secondary workstation that I have at home that is not this mastering studio or the one that I usually work at just on the other side of this wall. To have this kind of speaker at my home, I would be fully comfortable mastering at home through these, plus a good pair of headphones. Between these and the headphones, I think that I could hear exactly what's going on in the music and be able to address anything that needs to be addressed. So there you have it, the Kali Audio LP6s. Really cool speakers. I would love to own a pair myself. These are not mine. I wish they were. I mean, at $299 for the pair, like, that's crazy. I should have bought these yesterday. Okay, I gotta go. I'll see you in the next one. Peace.